Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today, what I wanted to do is check out a first impressions feature on an app called Thunk Notes. And I love the name to start off with. It's quite an interesting approach to sort of like the naming process. Normally, people go with like sort of names these days, but I quite like Thunk as a name. They're calling it the modern daily thinking tool. And I would say it's probably closer to being a comparison with sort of like a slightly less powerful version of Obsidian in Rome, but also sort of in the boat of this new sort of market like Clover, Craft, these sort of applications. So I thought I'd give it a go. As you can see, this is a website. Something you'll need to know with this app first is that it does have a 30-day free trial, but you do have to commit to one of the plans that they have. Let me tell you what the plans are before you begin so you don't get sort of overwhelmed and like, what options are available? Here they are. So it's there's a $12 per month plan, which is pretty pricey. There's a $96 per year plan, which is $8 per month, which isn't crazy. If you paid full price Evernote, it would probably work out the same. Not that they're completely different applications, but just giving you an idea for sort of pricing. And they have a five-year plan, which is $360. Again, this is more common with apps like Standard, Rome Research, where you're paying larger sums up front. So I've been playing around with it, and I wanted to give you some thoughts. The application in itself, what I think they're sort of doing differently with it is the sort of the templatizing process of it is actually pretty impressive. And the way that they've set it up, as well as the sort of the simplicity around the application. And that's, I think, what is different about it. Let me show you. So as you can see, this is my Thunk account. As you can imagine, it looks very similar to all of the other applications in structure. One thing I noticed is there's sort of a more differentiation between commands. So a slash command will give you sort of the regular inserting type blocks. So you can do headers, lists like a to-do list, and decorations as well, like code blocks and quotes, and inserting media. You can also insert templates, which I'll come to in a moment, as well as Twitter, which I haven't yet set up, but I'm sure has some sort of capability to reference a tweet or something like that. But it's got this feature, which I'll probably actually, I might touch on in the middle of this video, that does focus mode, which is actually something that I found a little bit different to some of the other applications and something that actually very impressive, I think, for writers. So let's go back and let's create a heading two, and I could say, this is my day today. One thing I did note as well is that it was actually fairly fast. Even being on Safari, I found that the experience has actually been fairly snappy and quite easy to do. The one thing you can do is slash command to do. There are shortcuts for all of these, but I haven't actually learned them yet. But for example, if I did say like clean fridge, I don't know. And what I can do is go over to this to-do area and just move myself out the way. You can see that these are your tasks for the day. And I quite like that because it's almost like just a zoom in view of your tasks for the day. And it's built in without any third party application having to sort of be installed and prepared for you to get that. If you were to say link something, so if I would go over here and at mention Thunk Notes, I didn't create one. I thought I created one earlier. I think I deleted it for the example. If I created a page called Thunk Notes, you can see that it automatically links there, allowing you to start creating a, not just like having the link there, but also start typing away on that note there. And you can also pin the note as well, which means it goes to the top of this links area. So you can have multiple threads going down as and multiple sort of notes being made. So what's nice is if you're journaling and you're writing down about your books that you're reading on today and what you learned specifically, you could, for example, have threads based on that, which is quite nice. And you can remove that toggle if you want as well. I just thought that was quite novel in terms of the way that they've done that. Now, let me touch on the at links. So the at links obviously bring up dates and notes, but you can link like to today and things like that. So obviously those pages will come up on the right-hand side. And what you can do as well is you can link to timestamps, which is really nice. So say I wanted to do my journal in the morning, timestamps come up and they're very quite clear cut in, you know, showing the timestamp and giving you a label. This might be helpful for journaling, but also for your notes across the day to differentiate them on when you took the time. And what's nice as well is, for example, let's say you're planning a meeting at 11:17. You could say, this is my meeting notes for then, which I think is pretty cool, in my opinion. And that's just something that I guess makes them a little bit different to the others. So templates, let me show you it. So if I type in insert template, I created one for week review. So as you can see, it's very much like Mem to some extent. You can paste a template into an existing note and it naturally appears, allowing you to fill that in. And templates are available over here and it looks like you can create as many as you want. One problem I noticed is that these buttons, maybe it's a Safari version, but these buttons aren't very well produced. Although obviously they work, they're not necessarily the most well put together buttons. As you can see here, there's some example templates. And what's cool as well, look like I had a data error there. What's cool as well is, oh, that's weird. So there's a trouble loading your data, make sure you're connected to the internet. Pretty sure I am, but again, it's a little bit temperamental today, so might give it a pause there. But the one thing that I saw in the demo, I don't know that was on the main website. You can see here that when you started your today area, you can see all of these different notes appear up here. So that's the benefit of the process of having all of these links up here. So if you did start a journal, then you can have all these elements or questions to ask yourself during the day, and regular things that pop up with those templates when they get started. So quite interesting in approach. Now, the thing I want to show you that I thought was quite novel was if I type in focus mode, you see this page comes up and it's quite interesting. So if I'm like, okay, I need that sort of zone in to write, and I'm writing something specific, what it does is it brings into this lovely mode where you're not disturbed by pretty much anything. And as you type, so I could just continue typing, you can see that it disappears and sort of makes it really focused on the typing experience. And you can exit that, and you can, if you want, tick, I believe, tick that off. I assume that means like that's been dealt with and done. But that focus mode is something that does differentiate it from the other applications. You can go about adding stuff for favorites and being able to use the explore function. Explore function works very much like Obsidian and Roam to some extent, I'd say a little bit more like Hypernotes. But you can see here that you can bring and start actual notes from there, and you can be able to interact with them, which is decent. And that's probably something that's going to take you a bit of time. It's saving you time there, and you can set up whether you want daily notes included or whether you want orphans set up, and search the graph as well. You can search in general just using the search bar. And there's recents down here and recent notes, and you can create a new note anytime here. So I would say the thing that makes this special is the elements, like the fact that you can use the today area and these links appear that are already linked in there, which means you can have like multiple threads going on, which is something you already have inside of apps like Obsidian and Roam, which means you have to sort of learn the setup for them. And you've also got To-Do here, which sort of clear cuts, cleans all of this. Like you could have a really messy today area, but the to-dos are quite clear and quite simple of what you need to get done for the day. So I like a lot of the things that are inside this application. I think it's a Thunk. It's very early days. I think that they obviously need to continue growing, and maybe that was an issue with the stability side of stuff, but it's been interesting to see them on Twitter. I think one thing that stands out as well is their branding. Really nice, really different, really like sort of community focused, I think. So I'm going to keep an eye on this one. And you can see here some of the examples. Ah, okay. So you can actually tweet through Thunk. That's how the Twitter integration works. I thought it was just like a simple link tweet and reference tweet, but you can actually tweet like a thread through Thunk, which is really cool. That's actually a little bit different. Their website, if you're viewing on Safari, is quite heavy. But anyway, folks, I thought that was an interesting application that might help you find a note taker. Early days for Thunk Notes, but not bad start. Fairly impressed. Early days, obviously 30-day free trial is pretty decent. Pricing is a little bit higher. The experience is decent for what you get, although obviously I think they've got a long way to go in terms of adding and reshuffling and building up the main experience. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed today's feature. If you did, please do subscribe, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.